How to prepare trading account? Now, problem number one, I am using the format what we have discussed earlier, because most of the problems will have minimum these items. Now, how we are going to use this format? Just if you have revised your format, it would be just the same what we discussed earlier. I also have a list of some direct expenses which we discussed earlier on the board. And coming to the problem, if any new direct expense is mentioned, I will be adding. So try to remember later and learn thoroughly the examples of your direct expenses. Now coming to first, prepare trading account of Srikanth Traders. So we have to prepare trading account of Srikanth Traders for the year ended, it is 31-12-2013. This is how you mention. Now first you are given stock on 1-1-2013. We are preparing the trading account for the year ended 31-12-2013. So stock on 1-1-13 would be your opening stock. So I am writing 9500 against opening stock in your format. Now the next item is purchases. So you are given purchases. Just check in the problem whether you are given purchase returns or not. Yes, we do have purchase returns. So what I will be doing is purchases of 12,200 I am writing in inner column and leave it. Now the next item is sales. When sales is given, also check if sales returns is given or not. We do have sales returns of 500, so I am going to write my sales value, which is 25,000 against sales in inner column. Now, next, after sales, you are given purchase returns. So, we have purchases minus returns. So, this purchase returns of 1200, I am writing against returns, which is nothing but purchase returns. So, when I remove 1200 from 12,200, the amount becomes 11,000. This is how you show in the outer column. Now, let us see what is the next item. The next item is wages. So wages is also there in the format. I'm entering 875 against wages. Now going across to the other side, we have carriage, and carriage is an example of direct expense. The word carriage, the word freight, the word carriage inward or freight inward all mean the same. So I'm just removing this word direct expense and writing here carriage. So we have carriage, the amount being 500. Now next we have factory rent. So here I have mentioned under direct expenses all factory expenses. So factory rent will be taking in trading account debit side. So to factory rent, the amount being 925. The next item is your sales returns. So from sales we should minus sales returns. So sales returns being 500, I'm going to deduct from sales, which is going to become 24,500. Now next item is customs duty. So customs duty is example of your direct expense. So I am adding here to the list custom duty, and also I am writing it on the debit side because it is the expense what you pay to get your goods cleared from your custom authorities. So customs duty, the amount being 800. Now next you are given closing stock. As already discussed, we said usually we take closing stock whenever purchases are not adjusted. How do you know whether purchases are not adjusted? Usually when you are given purchase returns and purchases and opening stock, generally we consider purchases as not adjusted. So because purchases are not adjusted, we are going to take closing stock on the credit side, 3100. Now, as usual, how you balance normally the ledgers, we balance this account. That is, you have a total of, if you compare both sides, the credit side total is more than debit side. The credit side total coming to 27,600. Since this total is more, I'm going to take on both the sides.